Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Outlate But Great. I hope you all had a great weekend. This week, our topic was given to us by Jim from Georgia, and it is a fantastic topic. It is, a coalition of evangelical Christians recently threatened to lead a relentless boycott against any NFL franchise that dares to draft a gay football player. Every year we see calls for boycotts against pro-LGBT companies and products and against anti-LGBT companies and products. Do you think boycotts are effective? What companies, products, or people do you boycott and why? Well, this is a very timely video because I am actually in the middle of boycotting something myself, but I'm going to get to that in just a minute. The boycott is not anything new. You know, boycotting has been going on for years and years and years and years. And we have plenty of LGBT boycotts that have gone on. From the LGBT standpoint, as the people doing the boycotting, look at the Salvation Army when it was made known that they take a huge stance against homosexuality. Did that work? Did that bring about anything positive? I don't know the answer to that. Then there was Chick-fil-A. You all remember when that was going down. And as a result of so much media coverage of LGBT people protesting Chick-fil-A, a record number of Christians turned out to go to Chick-fil-A, and it turns out that they had record-breaking sales that week. Now, I don't think that was a very effective boycott, but it certainly brought a lot of attention to Chick-fil-A, and I know a lot of people that still will never go and eat there again. And, you know, that food is not good for you anyway, people. Just stay away from there. And then recently, when we had the Olympics in Russia, there were plenty of anti-Russian boycotts going around, from just watching the Olympics in general to boycotting Stoli vodka, you know. And again, I don't know if anything worthwhile came out of those boycotts. You know, here in this country, we don't consume a lot of products that are made in Russia. And us boycotting our own athletes certainly did not help the morale of our athletes. However, I don't know of anybody personally who was doing that. And, you know, I think sometimes when we think about doing a boycott, the thing that we really need to consider more than anything is, what do we hope to achieve from the outcome, or what is the possible, you know, outcome that actually could be achieved if many people did it? And of course, you know, we all want to bring about change. Now, one company that I know of from years and years of following them that has produced tremendous results because of boycotts is Greenpeace. Greenpeace has put pressure on companies for years. I mean, when I first became a vegetarian back in 1987, I remember that Greenpeace was involved in many boycotts because of deforestation and this sort of thing. I mean, the whole tuna thing, do you remember when that was going on? And now I don't know if that has stuck all this time because of being a vegetarian. I haven't consumed any fish, you know, in over 25 years. But I do know that they had put pressure on companies like Nestle. And I think that wasn't actually that long ago, because of their palm oil supply. And so Nestle actually was pressured into signing a deforestation agreement with Greenpeace. And they put these practices into place, which are supposedly being monitored by the governments of the areas where this palm oil is harvested, and in efforts to not let the whole area become deforested because of Nestle and other companies like it. It's not just Nestle. So the most current, I don't know if you can really call this a boycott, it's actually more of a protest, the most current thing that I can think of off the top of my head was these Virginian Christians who are going to, it's starting in like August going through October, they are supposedly going to starve themselves for 40 days because they don't want gay marriage in Virginia. Good luck with that one, people, because, I mean, really, do you know anybody personally who would not eat for 40 days? It's ridiculous. It really is. My form of boycotting comes mostly because of companies that do animal testing. I am seriously against this. This is one of the very big reasons why I became a vegetarian in the first place, because of the way that animals are harvested for food. I'm not going to go off on that platform, or I'm not going to go off on that via this platform. However, because we're talking about boycotting, I wanted you to be aware of, especially the women out there, or anybody else, men too, who use any products made by Avon, Mary Kay, and Estee Lauder. Keep in mind that Estee Lauder owns Clinique, and you could look it up. I mean, there's another really popular cosmetic company that is now owned by Estee Lauder. Estee Lauder owns so much, it's unbelievable. Well, back in the 80s, I think it was like somewhere around 87 to 89, it might have been finalized in 89, there was a tremendous amount of pressure from PETA, which is People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, put on these companies because they were doing animal testing, just horrific things that were done to animals for the sake of beauty, and it just was awful. Well, back in, I think it was 89, they were basically pressured so much that they stopped doing the animal testing. So everything was hunky-dory for like, you know, 20 years or whatever. Then 2 years ago, or about a year and a half ago, it was found out that these same companies who had agreed to stop testing all of a sudden started testing on animals again under the radar. They didn't tell any of their customers, of course, that they started doing this again. And it is because of the demands of the Chinese government, because the Chinese government will not allow cosmetics to be produced or come into their country without animal testing. And so because these companies, these huge cosmetic companies, Estee Lauder is the biggest offender, who owns, like I said, Clinique and many, many other companies, they don't want to lose the entire country of China's business. So, of course, they are going to do the animal testing that is required by China to continue to sell their products there. You can look all this stuff up. It's all for public consumption. If you go to Estee, if you just Google, does Estee Lauder do animal testing, you will see a page right on Estee Lauder's website of frequently asked questions that tells you that they test on animals because of the Chinese government. And this is just the products that are going to China. However, do you really want to support a company who is doing this at all? And if you don't, there, if you go to PETA, PETA.org, I think it is, there is a slew of companies on there that are PETA approved, that do not test on animals, because nothing, especially the ladies who might be watching this, no amount of vanity or any makeup that's supposed to do what, I don't know, make you look a certain way or whatever, is worth what you could find out on your own if you just started doing a little bit of research to know what was still going on for the sake of beauty. And so I will step off my soapbox with that. But people do need to know that these companies have started resuming these tests again, and nobody seems to know about this because they have completely been doing this under the radar. And so do boycotts work? They do if the right companies with the right amount of power is doing the pressuring. Now, as far as individuals boycotting, I don't know, you know? I remember when the whole Exxon Valdez thing happened and everybody was boycotting Exxon and now BP and all these things, but like when they would have this day, for instance, and I'll close with this story, where you didn't buy gas on this certain day because it would put a huge dent in the company's. So everybody went the day before, and the company had record sales the day before, the day after. So does that really work? I mean, to me, logically, it doesn't seem like it does any good. However, if you can get the word out about certain products and you can get the word out to companies that can make a difference, then perhaps the larger companies like Greenpeace and PETA, two prime examples of companies that effectively did boycotts and have had good things come out of them. So I would love to hear your thoughts on this. Do you boycott anything? Please tell me why. I really wish we still, do we still have the video response feature on this on YouTube? I mean, is this even a thing anymore? Because I really miss video responses. So anyway, I hope that you all have a great week, and please check out the things that I was talking about, and you know, let me know what your thoughts are. Okay, talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.